Students, now let's solve that question number 13. If R and S be the two relations on any set A, then show that, you know, if this symbol is called the included, R is included in S and R inverse is also included in S inverse, and R union T whole inverse, then R inverse union T inverse. We have to solve these two questions now. Let's have a look how to solve this. Student, for the number 13 question, you know, solution I'm writing here. So let, for the first one, this is for Roman one, let x comma y belongs to R inverse. Let's have a take that x comma y belongs to R inverse. So if it is x comma y belongs to R inverse, then y comma x belongs to R. Obviously, you know, if it is R inverse, then y comma x is the belongs to R. Now look, student, after that, so here in the question it is mentioned that R and S be the two relation on any set A, which means, you know, in place of y comma x we may write here s also, because, you know, since R is included in S, so if it is do so, then x comma y, you know, belongs to S inverse, and after that we can say that x comma y belongs to R inverse, and here is x comma also, so we can say that x comma y, then therefore we can say that R inverse is included in S inverse. The first one is proved now. I repeat again, let us take first that x comma y belongs to R inverse, then y comma x belongs to R. So since R is included in S, and this part, you know, is given in the question, if R is included in S, then we have to show that R inverse belongs to S inverse. So in place of R included means what? All these elements of R belongs to S, so obviously this belongs to R, which means this belongs to S also. And now if I write here x comma y, which means this belongs to S inverse. So first one is proved. Now second one, Roman 2. Let's have a look how to solve this Roman 2. Hello student, question number 2 means 13 Roman 2, and let x comma y belongs to, you know, R union T inverse. So if it is do so, then y comma x belongs to R union T. If this value belongs to R union T inverse, so y comma x belongs to R union T. So now look here, y comma x belongs to R, or y comma x belongs to T, split up. Now look, here we can say that x comma y belongs to R inverse. This is y comma x belongs to R, which means x comma y belongs to R inverse, or here also x comma y belongs to T inverse. Now look, after that, now look student, x comma y belongs to R inverse and x comma y belongs to T inverse also, which means x comma y, both these elements belongs to R inverse union T inverse. So we can say that, therefore we can say that, you know, look, x comma y belongs to R union T inverse, and here also x comma y belongs to R inverse union T inverse. So we can say that, you know, R union T inverse is the, we can say that R union T inverse is the, this symbol is called the subset of, you know, R inverse union T inverse, the first one. So I'm taking this one as equation number 1. Now next one, this symbol indicate that all these elements of this set union belongs to this one. Now look, converse the second one, look the next part. Now here, let x comma y belongs to R inverse union T inverse. So students, x comma y belongs to R inverse, or x comma y belongs to, you know, T inverse. Now look, next one, after that, if I write here y comma x belongs to R, or y comma x belongs to T. Now look, here both these elements belongs to R and T, so we can say that y comma x belongs to R union T. And next one would be then x comma y belongs to R union T whole thing inverse. Now look, here also we can say that the last line, therefore R inverse union T inverse is subset of R union T whole thing inverse. This is the equation number 2. Now look, from 1 and from 2 both are same, so we can say that from 1 and 2 we can say that R union T whole thing inverse equal to R inverse union T inverse, hence proved. One more thing, student, this question number 13 from exercise 1.3 is very important.